you know that 1/3 of our food is impacted by the work of honeybees? It's true. Almond growers depend heavily on honeybee pollination. Today, the state of California is the biggest producer of almonds, growing almost 80% of the world's supply. But how do honeybees have such an international impact on agriculture if the hives stay stationary? The answer to that question is what we will be learning about today. My name is Virginia Allen, and I am the 2020 Texas Honey Queen. As a state representative for the Texas Beekeepers Association, I teach people clear across the great state of Texas about honeybees and their sweet honey. I have taught topical presentations and cooking demonstrations to all ages and am available for radio and television interviews as well. If you would like more information about our program or to request a presentation or interview, please visit our website at texasbeekeepers.org or email us at texashoneyqueenchair@gmail.com. Be sure to check out our Facebook and Instagram pages for more fun facts and exciting information. So how do honeybees make such an impact? The answer is through migratory pollination. Commercial beekeepers have hundreds of beehives that they will load onto a tractor trailer and ship to orchards across the country. For bees to properly pollinate the crops effectively, each flower needs multiple visits. For instance, watermelon flowers need a minimum of 8 visits to receive sufficient amount of pollen grain. While some plants have the capability to self-pollinate or pass on pollen through using wind, insects can help these plants by collecting and delivering more pollen to each flower, resulting in a higher crop yield, both in quantity and quality. While honeybees do not pollinate bulk crops like corn and wheat, we can taste most of their efforts in the specialty crops, which the USDA defines as fruits, veggies, tree nuts, and herbs. The picture on the left shows how much produce we have with honeybee pollination, and the picture on the right is without honeybee pollination. Pretty amazing, isn't it? Here we find the dairy aisle where we buy our morning yogurt, milk for cereal, smooth butter, and a diversity of cheeses. These pictures show that honeybees also influence the dairy industry through pollination of alfalfa, which the dairy cows eat. In the next aisle over, we can also buy ground beef for hamburgers or a nice steak for a cozy home-cooked meal. As I mentioned earlier, honeybees assist American agriculture by contributing $15 to $20 billion each year. Surprisingly, only 2% of those profits come from honey sales. The majority of that money comes from their work as pollinators. Honeybees pollinate over 90 crops in North America, providing us with many varieties of specialty foods and even cotton. Even though we usually think of honeybees only helping the food crops, by pollinating cotton, they extend their reach into the textile industry as well. Let's go back to the beginning, to the people who maintain the bees. Listen as they explain how they started beekeeping.
My name is Russell Ditford. My wife, Lisa Ditford, and we are sideline beekeepers. We're building a business to
develop a retirement.
Yeah.
To do when we retire in a few years.
My name's Chris Moore. I started back in 99 doing this. I went to work for a commercial beekeeper, and then unfortunately he had to file bankruptcy. The mites had destroyed his colony, so I was able to get a beginning farm loan and basically picked up what he had started.
My name is Skip Talper. I am a John. My dad's a John, so that's why I go by Skip. We're Sabine Creek Honey Farm. My dad's been doing it 30 plus years, and when I retired from the military, I joined the team in 2014. As most people know, and I tell in my stories, I hated bees. That's why I got away and joined the military. But then, you know, as I got my business degree and started using the company as my models for my business programs, and I got really interested in the bees and being self-employed. I've been doing that since 2014. So I'm basically the operation manager for Sabine Creek Honey Farm. So I basically do all the field work.
In order to fulfill contracts with the crop growers, beekeepers must send strong colonies in clean equipment. The hive selection process is extremely important and labor intensive. Along the trucker's routes, there are three main inspection points. Starting in the apiary, the Texas Apiary Inspection Service will check the colonies for pests and diseases that can be transmitted to other colonies while out of state. After passing an inspection, the TAIS agent will grant the beekeeper an exportation permit. The beekeeper will also need to apply for importation permits for each state that the bees will be visiting. At the southern border of California, the load will be checked for the presence of any hitchhiker insects, like fire ants, that could disrupt California's ecosystem. Finally, the hives will be checked once more at the orchard to confirm that the delivery matches the contract.
The main inspection point from like the Texas southern area is coming out of Needles. They're looking for any kind of like dirt that would be housing of an ant. I mean, one ant will stop a whole load. But all the truckers that do bee hauling had to be certified and insured. The trucker we've used, he's been through the border between 15 and 30 minutes, and some guys sat there for hours.
To obtain pollination contracts, beekeepers may either work directly with the grower or work with a broker who serves as an intermediary. Now that we know how beekeepers prepare, inspect, and ship their hives, let's look into the benefits of this kind of pollination for the beekeepers. The first benefit of migratory pollination is, you guessed it, pollen. The worker bees bring increased pollen stores to the hive, and the bee population will expand exponentially. When the bees return from pollinating orchards, beekeepers are able to split the large hive into 3 to 4 smaller hives and either sell those hives or expand their company. The second benefit from migratory beekeeping is the production of honey from select crops. Contrary to popular belief, not all crops produce honey, and even if they did, you wouldn't want it.
Most of our honey production during pollination is zero. Almond honey, it's kind of a bitter tasting honey, is usually not very prevalent. It's enough to keep the bees going, so we mainly use that for growth of bees.
Meanwhile, some crops and surrounding foliage produce flavor-packed wildflower honey.
Well, I mean, it's basically Southeast Texas wildflower honey, which is what's known as tallow honey. And the West Texas is just known as cotton honey.
The bigger crops up north is the canola and the clover. It's just a different type of honey. It's just a northern flavor that they like. A lot of the northern guys that we know that winter over here call it Texas motor oil honey because it's so dark.
One year we did send our hives down South Texas, and it was watermelon and cantaloupe. We kept that honey separate from our local honey. We didn't want to not be able to say to our customers in Collin County that it was local honey. So we literally kept that honey separate.
The third benefit of migratory beekeeping is the monetary profits from growers. With those earnings, the beekeeper is able to care for his hives during the summer dearth and winter months. This presentation would be incomplete if I did not address some of the risks of migratory beekeeping. Because beekeeping is outside, is weather dependent, and involves temperature sensitive insects, it can be a challenging and unpredictable business. Even with ventilated protective suits, beekeepers can easily overheat in the hot summer sun. Most often, the weather controls when we can get out to our bee yards and do inspections and supplemental feedings. Other risks include flooding, tornadoes, vandalism, overheating on road trips, unforeseen diseases and pest infections, muddy or impassable roads, and other highway drivers. Beekeepers can do their part by not overloading the trucks. This can cause them to be top heavy and susceptible to rolling over during regular turns. You can do your part by driving safely around semis and other cars. Remember, heavy semi trucks cannot stop as quickly as your lightweight Prius. Leave them room when you pull over. A good rule of thumb is if you can see both of their headlights in your car's side mirror, then it's safe to change lanes. Let's review what we learned today with a short test. If you need more time, simply pause the video. Are you ready? Get set. Let's go. Honeybees are very important to our food supply. What percentage of our food do honeybees impact? The correct answer is C. Honeybees impact 60% of our food. While honeybees make honey, do all plants produce nectar? The correct answer is B. Not all plants produce nectar. Honeybees transfer pollen from one flower to another of the same species. What crop does not require insect pollination? The correct answer is B. Wheat pollen is transferred by the wind and does not require insect pollination. In order to pass export and import inspections, what must the beekeeper do? The correct answer is C. Beekeepers need to use clean equipment to pass inspections. If you see a bee-carrying semi-truck overturn, what should you do? The correct answer is D. If you see a bee-carrying semi-truck overturn, you should calmly call 911, keep your windows closed, and navigate around debris. Driving over bee equipment should be avoided as the splintered wood may puncture your tires or damage the undercarriage of your car. Today, we learned how honeybees help you. What are some ways that you can help them? The correct answer is I. You can help honeybees by learning more about them and changing your buying and gardening habits. Did you get all 6 questions correct? Or did you miss a few? Let me know in the comments below. I hope you enjoyed learning about the impact of honeybees on agriculture and the fascinating world of migratory beekeeping. Check out some of our other videos and follow us on Facebook and Instagram. If you would like to schedule us to visit your organization, see the link in the video description. Remember to support your local beekeeper by eating some honey today.